Good morning guys, and welcome to our economics session. Now so far I have told you what is utility, what is total utility and marginal utility. But to give you a more detailed idea in this concept, I am going to teach you the same concepts but in so much depth that you will be satisfied. Okay, like you know what is utility? Utility is nothing but want satisfying power of a commodity. Now this same sentence you have to keep in mind, you have to remember it, okay? Utility is the want satisfying power of a commodity. When I say want satisfying power, I obviously mean that it is a psychological concept. The one thing that has utility for me may or may not have utility for some other person, right? For example, you can say that a book has utility to a literate person only. It may not have utility to illiterate person. So utility is a subjective concept, and to study this further, there are basically two types of measurements or two types of approach that are taken by various classical economists. So the first concept is that of the cardinal approach, right? Cardinal approach. When you say cardinal, in the features we have seen that utility is actually not cardinally measurable. Means when you say cardinal, you mean in numbers. So utility cannot be measured in numbers. For example, if I say if I demand a chocolate, then I cannot say how many units of utility I get from consumption of that chocolate, or how much, if I am thirsty, then how much utility will the bottle of water provide me. So I cannot measure it in terms of number, but taking the cardinal approach, we assume that the utility can be measured in numbers. Now, in the very beginning of our introduction, I told you that there are various assumptions which form a basis of major microeconomic theories. So this is a type of assumption where I say that in cardinal approach, for understanding the concept of utility, basically we measure or we study the concept of utility in two different types of approaches. First is cardinal approach and second is ordinal approach. We will come to ordinal approach later in this session. But currently, I am talking about the cardinal approach. And what exactly is the cardinal approach? Is that when you talk about cardinal measurement, you talk about measuring something, in this case, utility. So you assume that utility can be measured in numbers, right? And this entire cardinal approach was given by none other than Professor Alfred Marshall. Professor Alfred Marshall, this word, this name, you will come across many, many times in the microeconomic theory, because the microeconomic study or microeconomics theory was popularized by Professor Alfred Marshall. Majority of theories given and, you know, become a norm in microeconomic theory is given by Professor Alfred Marshall. So he tried to explain the cardinal approach through the law of DMU. DMU stands for diminishing marginal utility. Now, in cardinal approach, the word that you have to keep in mind is that of diminishing. Okay? For your reference, I'll just tell you what the statement of DMU, as given by Professor Alfred Marshall, states. It states that the additional benefit that a consumer derives from consumption of one extra unit, what happens to that additional benefit? That diminishes with every increase in the consumption, right? Means this sentence, when you read it, may seem a little bit confusing, or it may feel a little, you may feel bewildered by reading it, but I'll give you a simple example. If you are thirsty and I offer you a glass of water, what's going to happen? The first sip that you're going to take is the biggest one, right? And then you'll stop, you'll take a breath, then you will drink. As you go on consuming, what do you feel? Is that your thirst is getting satisfied. Means now the glass of water is having less and lesser utility for you. right? You may even stop at third sip of water and there might be still some water remaining in the glass, and what you will say is, okay, I am done, thank you, my thirst is satisfied. It means what? The additional benefit, called as marginal utility. The additional benefit that a consumer derives. From where does he derive this additional benefit? By consuming one extra unit. As you go on taking another and another sip of water, your utility, your satisfaction is what? Reduced, right? When you take first sip, that has the greatest utility. Means the marginal utility with every step of the way will diminish. You do not see decrease here. There is a reason for that. That I'll explain you in further few minutes only, but you have to understand that the law of DMU uses the word diminishing for marginal utility. Okay, so this is basically a brief idea of law of DMU, which explains us the concept of utility using the cardinal approach. Now let's move forward to some numerical examples so that you understand this concept of diminishing marginal utility or the law of diminishing marginal utility in a better way. Now in economics, many a times you will, you know, come across various theories, various concepts which may seem very confusing to you when you read them. But when you associate the same thing in some numerical example known as the schedule, the numerical examples are known as schedules, okay, and the diagrams are known as the graph, okay, the curve or the graph and the schedule. It will help you to understand these same concepts in a better and detailed way. You will also be able to remember it quite clearly, okay. Now what does this schedule show us? It shows us units consumed. Now for the law of diminishing marginal utility to actually, you know, take place, you are assuming that the units that you are consuming should be what? Consecutive. It should not be like now you are taking one sip of water and after 3 hours you are taking another sip of water. What will happen then? Obviously your utility will not diminish. It will increase, because after 3 hours that will be again your first sip of water. So we are thinking, or we are assuming here again, that the units that you consume are what? Consecutive, or you can say continuous. Okay. Second column shows us total utility. What is total utility? As the name suggests, it is the total utility, total satisfaction that you derive from the consumption of a particular commodity. Like I said, from first sip to the last sip of water, total how much utility you got, that utility is the TU, or the total utility. Now as you saw, the formula for total utility is nothing but summation of marginal utility, right? It's not a rocket science. See, every sip that you take of that glass of water is what? Your additional and additional utilities. When you combine all those utilities, you will say how much that water gave you satisfaction. That is nothing but your total utility, correct? Now in the features here, just deviating from this law of DMU, in the definition or in the features, we saw that utility and satisfaction are not the same concepts. It's very much true. These are not the same concepts, but you have to understand the idea behind this, that utility is always related to satisfaction. If something does not have the ability to satisfy your demand or satisfy your want or need, it will not have utility for you. Okay? So when you say marginal utility, you are talking about the additional, the extra benefit that you got from consuming an additional or extra product. For example, when I consumed one unit, I got 10 units of marginal utility. How did I come across this 10? Because I have my total utility. So here I think that when I take the first sip of water, I get 10 utils of utility. Now what is utils? Utils is nothing but the unit of measuring your utility. So if I get 10 utils of utility, means prior to this I was very thirsty, I did not have water, I had this thirst. So when I took this first sip, at that time I had 10 utils of utility. So before this, in 0, I had 0 utility. So 10 minus 0 is 10. So the formula that can come is TU of N means your current consumption minus TU of N minus 1 means the consumption prior to this unit. So when you talk about second unit, you can see the marginal utility is 8. Why is it 8? Because the total utility is 18. So when it is 18 minus, this is TU of N means TU of 2 minus TU of N minus 1 means prior to this, how many units were there? Obviously 1 units. What was my total utility? 10. So here I got this 8 as a function of 18 subtracted 10. Okay, this is how you come across all these things. Now here, instead of getting into the arithmetical things, we will see what it means economically. What inference, what conclusion can we draw from this law of diminishing marginal utility? As you can see, the total utility with each consumption of unit goes on increasing, correct? But correspondingly, the marginal utility goes on decreasing. Why is it so? Because the law of DMU says that the additional benefit that a consumer derives from consumption of extra unit, what happens to that additional benefit? That it diminishes with every increase in the consumption of the stock that he already has, or diminishes with every increase in the consumption. Now, the idea behind diminishing marginal utility, I just told you that as you go on consuming more and more of the same product, your satisfaction goes on decreasing, because your satisfaction is what? It is completed. Your want is being satisfied. Then there will come one point where you will say, okay, I am done. Means you are fully satisfied. Means what will happen is your satisfaction level will be what? The highest. Your want is totally satisfied. Means the total utility at the highest will be your point of full satisfaction. But what will happen to this additional benefit or marginal utility when your total utility is maximum? Means now you are fully satisfied. Will the additional consumption over this level of full satisfaction give you any more satisfaction? Means when you say that I am done, okay, my thirst is fulfilled, now I don't want any more water. And if I force you again, what will happen? If you drink one more sip of water, it might be, or it might happen that you might vomit, right? You might say, no, I am fully satisfied, I cannot have any more water. Means the additional sip that you will consume will not give you any additional benefit. Means the marginal utility will be zero. There will be no additional benefit. So this point where TU is what? Maximum. And MU means the additional utility, additional satisfaction, marginal utility is zero. This is called as the point of satiety. Point of satiety. Now what do you mean by point of satiety? Point of satiety means the point of full satisfaction. Means now the unit that you have, the commodity that you have been consuming has reached its full satisfaction level. Means at 6 units of this commodity, you are fully satisfied. But what happens if you go on consuming it further? Like I said, you might vomit. Means now you are going into a point where you do not get utility, but whatever you have consumed, that is also coming out. Means you are in the negative benefit. Now there is no benefit, absolutely zero. But beyond that point, also if you are deciding to consume, then it will be negative, and total utility, your total satisfaction will also decrease, because now that you have vomited, what is going to happen is your satisfaction has decreased. So the TU will never decrease up to the point of full satisfaction, because as you go on consuming certain commodity, your need is being satisfied, means your total utility will definitely go on increasing. Correspondingly, the MU or the marginal utility will go on decreasing, right? But when the marginal utility is zero, means the additional extra consumption is not going to satisfy you anymore, that is called as the point of satiety. But beyond that also, if you decide to consume, what is going to happen is that the marginal utility will be negative, means it is minus 2, so 30 minus 2 will become your 28, so summation of MU. When you summation, when you add these two, you will get total utility. When you subtract TU of N minus TU of N minus 1, you will get marginal utility. So as you can see, from 30 your total utility has come to 28. This only and only happens in the case where the marginal utility is what? Negative. So this point does not give you utility, but it is in fact called as disutility. It is creating a disutility, a negative benefit. There is no satisfaction absolutely in this case when you consume beyond the point of full satisfaction. Okay, so this was our schedule. To understand this even better, the same schedule we will see through a graphical representation. This is your first graph that you are learning in economics. So I'll give you some cues for this. When you draw this x-axis and y-axis, always, always, always remember that on x-axis you measure quantity. On x-axis, always the quantity is measured, and whatever is the remaining variable, that you can see in what? The y-axis. So here, if I plot quantity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay? And the TU and the MU. So what's going to happen? See, when I consume the first unit, the marginal utility and the total utility, okay, let us first plot 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. What is the most? It is 30, so 35 will work. So it is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 and 35. Okay, so let's plot. When you consume one unit, what happens is the total utility and marginal utility both are what? 10. So this is your first point, correct? So second utility, as you go on consuming it further, the total utility rises to 18. So when you consume the second product, it rises to 18 somewhere here, okay? Then goes to 24. Then third goes to 24, somewhere here. Then fourth, as you consume, it goes to 28, which is somewhere again here. But when you consume fifth point, then it comes to the full satisfaction, that is here. Okay, somewhere here. Okay, but when you consume sixth, again you see that in sixth also the consumption is the same, means in the sixth unit also you have the same 30 utils of utility. And then obviously beyond the full satisfaction level it will reduce and come to 28. So it is here 28. Now when you join these points, what do you come across is this. This is your TU, okay? And when you plot MU, what's going to happen? First unit is giving you a 2, right? 3 units are giving 24 here, okay? 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. 10, it is already plotted. Then 6, means below this. Then 4, even below. Here, then 2, very below, then it is 0, over here, and then it is negative, it goes to minus 2, means somewhere here. So it is 10, then it will go to 8. Okay, we did not plot 8. 10, then 8. We plot it 8 here, then we plot 6 somewhere here, then 4, then 2, then here. And when you plot the same thing over here, what you get is, this is 8, see, this is your MU curve. Now, what you have to see here, what you have to understand here is, if you get this TU and MU curve over here, what is happening? When the MU is decreasing or diminishing, as you can say, when the MU is diminishing, TU is still what? Increasing. Increasing. Okay? Here it is increasing rapidly, but you can say it is bending. Means, if I say some curve is increasing, I can say it increases like this. But as you can observe, the curve is a little bent. Why is a little bent? Because we say that TU curve increases but at a diminishing rate, because additional and additional quantity is less. Means, first I get 10 utils of satisfaction, then I get 18. Means, I say that I am getting an additional satisfaction of 8 utils. But as I consume one more, what do I observe? That it goes on to 24. But when I compare this, I see that the first unit additional satisfaction that I got was 10. Then the additional satisfaction goes on decreasing. Means, although the consumption of a unit is contributing to my total utility, but the additional or the marginal utility that I am getting is what? Diminishing. So it increases but at a diminishing rate. Increases but at a diminishing rate. TU curve increases at a diminishing rate. On the other hand, MU curve is downward sloping always. And see, this is the most important point, that when MU curve is zero, when it touches the x-axis, means when MU is zero, the curve of TU should be maximum. This is the first point you have to remember in the graph, as a relationship between TU and MU, that when TU is highest, as you can see, 30 is highest at 0.5 also, at 0.6 also. Then why did we choose 0.6? It is because the additional consumption, you have to check whether it is increasing or decreasing or remaining constant. So it is remaining constant, means it is the maximum or the highest value. So when additional benefit is zero, at that time TU should be maximum. This is your point of satiety, when your MU curve touches the x-axis. What happens further is, this utility, only when there is a negative to your MU curve, when MU curve becomes negative, only at that point TU will decrease, TU curve will decrease, otherwise TU curve always increases. The second point is, TU will only decrease when MU is what? Negative. When MU is negative. This is the disutility. So that is why when you talk about the shape of a TU curve, it is increasing but at a diminishing rate. Right? It is an inverse U-shaped curve, and MU curve is sloping downwards, can become zero and then become negative. MU curve is always diminishing. Okay? And MU can be negative, but TU can never be negative. What you will say? I consumed a product and I got a negative utility. It's not possible. Either you get a satisfaction or you don't. If you are not getting a satisfaction, you might not as well demand the product. Means, there will be no utility for a product. That product you will never demand. Because utility is the basis of demand. You purchase or you demand only those types of products which you think will satisfy your need. So basically, this was the law of diminishing marginal utility as presented by Professor Alfred Marshall, which talks about the relationship between the TU and the MU. Once again, in short, I will explain what is the relationship between TU and MU. As a consumer goes on consuming additional units, the TU increases, but the MU, that is the marginal utility, the additional benefit, goes on decreasing or diminishing, and they reach a point where consumer is fully satisfied, means his total utility is maximum and additional utility is zero. He will get no more satisfaction from consuming an additional unit, so he should probably stop, because this is the point of satiety. Satiety means point of full satisfaction. Your want is fully satisfied. But in ignorance, if he does what? Consumes even more, what will happen is his marginal utility will be negative, means his total utility will diminish. So here through arithmetics, I think you can arrive at the value. But when you draw this figure, even if you don't plot directly, if you draw this figure, what you have to keep in mind that when TU is maximum, at that point your MU should touch the x-axis, means become zero, because this is your point of full satisfaction. And when your curve decreases, at that time MU should become negative. Okay, so whenever you explain the relationship, you can say when MU is decreasing, what happens to TU? It is always increasing. Why? Because even if it is decreasing, it is contributing something to the total utility. That is why total utility is increasing with every unit of consumption. Second thing, when MU is zero, what is the value of TU? It is maximum. And when MU finally becomes negative, there is a disutility. At that point of time, TU will also decrease. Okay, so that's all for today. This is our law of diminishing marginal utility, and this is our cardinal approach in which we assume that utility can be measured in numbers, although the truth is that it cannot be measured in numbers. But to understand the law of DMU, Professor Alfred Marshall made an assumption which we all have to abide by, is that utility is cardinally measurable, can be measured in numbers. The unit that you use to measure utility is utils, U-T-I-L-S, utils. Okay, so in the next session we will see about the ordinal approach, but this is your cardinal approach. Okay, thank you.